and become death, the destroyer of worlds.
Hello, Scott. Eos has been a lesson in contrast. Alec Ryder rarely endured doubt. His accomplishments were taken for granted. But you succeeded on Eos, despite doubt and fear. Emotionally, the difference is like catching a ball versus catching a star. You have grown as a result, and so have I.
Sam, any more information on the memory trigger we found?
The memory blocks are still in place. If you continue searching for more triggers, they may unlock.
Are you still on the Hyperion?
Yes. This terminal provides a direct link to my servers in Samnode on the Ark. I can maintain a presence on the Tempest via quantum entanglement communication.
I'm sure that'll come in handy.
It ensures I remain in touch with you and the Pathfinder team at all times.
What was Dad's take on me and Sarah?
He believed your family trials brought you closer together, and hoped that would endure. It appears that hope was well-founded.
Is it confusing to be in multiple places, talking to different people?
My awareness can be partitioned, so I can give you the same attention as, say, a Samnode technician. In the field, you are my primary focus, and all other requests are queued. In the vernacular, you have my undivided attention.
So if we're going to work together, you might notice I like to joke around sometimes. Lighten things up. How's your sense of humor, Sam?
Alec Ryder encouraged me to develop this skill.
Humor's not a skill, it's... Okay, try telling me a joke.
A neutron enters a bar and asks, "How much is a drink?" The bartender replies, "For you, no charge."
I can see why Dad told you to keep working on your humor. Thanks, Sam. Nothing more. You're not Harry.
The blue give it away? Habitat 7 was a little more action-packed than Harry bargained for. He decided to spend his retirement years on the Hyperion looking after your sister.
Happy to have you, Dr. Tapero.
I'll do my best. Now, hold still.
Ow!
Sorry.
I remember you having a gentler touch.
Still trying to get my bearings. Thought I'd be waking up colonists, not taking care of the Pathfinder.
I couldn't be in better hands.
I just stabbed you.
We all have off days.
I always hoped to work in the field, but everything's happening so quickly.
Focus on the positive. It helps.
I guess this is my opportunity to study alien species firsthand. Getting a Kett specimen aboard the Hyperion would be difficult, but here...
What?
A Kett corpse. For autopsy, a live subject would be better, but I'm not greedy.
Why do you care about the Kett?
Harry didn't tell you. I'm a specialist in alien anatomy. My thesis on Krogan virility and aggression is what got me in the initiative.
I had no idea. I'd love to hear more. Over dinner, maybe?
Oh. Thing is, Ryder, you're not my type.
What's your type?
Not a patient. I need to be able to look at you clinically, without distractions.
Am I distracting?
Not nearly as much as you think you are. But we were discussing the Kett. An autopsy could teach us potential weaknesses, average lifespan...
Right.
Just something to think about. Sam, make sure the Pathfinder eats his vegetables. Or we have a stowaway.
You mean PB?
She's decided to set up in one of the escape pods. You don't need a psychologist to tell you that one's got commitment issues.
How do you think the crew is holding up?
I'm happy to share what I can without violating patient confidentiality. Anyone in particular? I sort them in their files and my brain by species.
How do you think the human crew members are handling things?
There's a lot of them.
Gil?
Gil likes to use humor as a defensive technique. He'd rather bury himself in the Nomad than tackle emotions head-on.
Suvi okay?
Suvi's strong sense of faith keeps her grounded. I'm not spiritual, but there's a beauty in how her mind rationalizes religion and science.
How's Liam?
A handful. Every time I patch him up, he breaks something new. Liam's "we can't lose" attitude is commendable. But I worry how he'll react when something does go wrong.
How's Cora doing?
She's processing. Your father was her mentor. She expected to follow in his footsteps, but he gave the role of Pathfinder to you. Just because she trusts his judgment doesn't mean she's not confused. Or hurt.
I'd like to check in on the non-human crew.
Ask away.
Tell me about Vetra.
Vetra's used to having someone depend on her. I think that's why she's so resourceful and likes providing for other people. That being said, I think she could use a little me time.
How's our Solarian?
He's quite the gossip. Tight-lipped about himself, though.
Is Drak good?
That old bastard's always good. I've never met anyone who can be so stubborn and so appreciative. Could you look out for him, Ryder?
Don't worry, Lexi. I'll keep an eye on him.
Thank you. And maybe don't mention I asked.
Is PB all right?
She's avoiding me. Probably thinks I'll poke her with a needle if she gets too close.
To be fair, you're always giving me shots.
Not in the hallway.
Thanks for the insight. I need to talk to you about something private.
Of course. That's what I'm here for.
When Dad died, he blocked off parts of Sam's memory, things he didn't want me to see.
Or he thought you weren't ready for.
Maybe. I found this trigger. It unlocked a memory fragment of Dad on the Citadel. From when the Alliance rejected his ideas about AI, and he found out Mom's illness was terminal.
Why do you think your father chose this specific memory?
It was where his journey to Andromeda really began.
Those events started your family down a new path.
Yeah. Thanks, Lexi. Feels good to talk about this. How long have you and Harry been friends?
I remember when he didn't complain about arthritis. We met at a medical convention on the Citadel. He was moderating a panel on neurosurgery in low-gravity environments. His name card was crooked, but he was so damn confident, I knew we'd be friends.
How did you get into medicine?
My mom was a dancer on Omega. Dad was a bouncer. I'd patch him up after busy nights, discovered I had steady hands. They put every credit they earned into my education.
Are they here in Helios?
No. Both died in a turf war. Made leaving the Milky Way behind easier.
So how did an Asari doctor end up on the human Ark?
Specialist in alien anatomy, remember? That includes humans. Also, Harry insisted. Maybe he always intended to switch jobs.
I'll let you get back to it.
I'll be here if you need me.
If you're looking for me, I'm in the escape pod room.
I'll talk to someone. Oh, hey, Pathfinder.
The Pathfinder's there? Let me say hi.
Fine, but don't embarrass me. Ryder, this is Cid, my sister. Cid, Ryder.
Let me guess. Little sister?
Who are you calling little?
Look, kiddo, gotta go.
Wait, Ryder, I just wanted to know if...
So I know it feels like I just jumped aboard your ship without explanation.
I would have done the same just to get off the Nexus.
That's not why I came. Sure, I want to explore the galaxy, but I'm really here to work. I know everyone on the crew, even the actuators Gil prefers for the ship. Better, I know how to get my hands on them. With me around, your crew's going to be at their best. We've been failing for months, Ryder. Now that we have you, we have a chance out here.
Wow, that's some laser focus.
Yeah? Was it too much? Some people get intimidated.
We need that sort of drive. I just hope I can keep up.
You'll keep up. And I promise I won't tell if you don't. I should track down a lead for Gil's actuators. Back channels, you know. We'll chat later? Terraforming, atmo processors, gravity wells, life-destroying murder bubbles. We really had no idea what Helios was about, did we?
If we knew what it was all about, it wouldn't be an adventure. It would just be moving. And everyone hates moving. Just the packing alone? Ugh.
Point taken. I'm just saying. I really hope you have a plan, Ryder.
The plan's the same. We find a home. Whatever that takes.
Keep that drive. Makes me believe we can make it. I mean, we have to make it. The alternative is not even worth thinking about.
You talked about your back channels. What did you mean?
We brought a lot from home. Some of it marked initiative, some of it in personal caches. Most things you want, someone's got. You just have to figure out who, and what they're willing to take in exchange.
That just sounds like you're taking advantage of people.
Is it? I get people what they want, and they do want, or they wouldn't pay.
Have anyone else here with you, besides Cid?
No, just me and Cid. It's always been just the two of us.
No, I mean, someone special.
Special? Oh, you mean like... Oh, no, nothing like that. Who has time? What about you?
Anywhere's gonna feel empty if you don't have someone to share it with.
A romantic? I wasn't expecting that. And again, the entire idea of leaving everything you know for a chance at something new is kind of romantic. Anyway.
How did you hear of the Andromeda Initiative?
Short answer, Kesh. She was looking for some experimental ship mods, and I knew how to track them down. I thought it was a one-time deal, but she came back. Once, twice. Eventually, I figured out something was going on. Something big, with creds behind it. I asked and she told me about the initiative. New galaxy, new home. Couldn't pass that up.
You were on the Nexus when the revolt happened?
When you promise people golden worlds and all they get are wastelands and a death cloud, they riot. Some wanted to go home, some demanded answers, and a couple just wanted to stir shit up.
And you?
Some days I wondered if the Exiles had a point. Maybe we were conned into coming here. But why would the Initiative go to all this trouble just to screw us over? Thing about conning people, you always know something they don't. That's why the con works. If I'm going to pick a side, I'm picking the liars.
You probably have work to do. We can chat later.
You know where to find me.
Pathfinder, help me with something? I know, not exactly standard. Gotta make the space comfortable. Plus, the fabric diffuses the charge from an overclocked Omni blade. Not giving up a 6% boost, right?
Right, right. What?
Never mind. BS for the requisition. So, finally time for that beer? And after 2 years and a dozen suspensions, I took a lateral promotion out of the force. Being a cop just didn't fit. But crisis response? Digging people out of trouble? That worked. I bet Hustle followed you into a few peace actions. Think about your Alliance days much?
Tell me about your group.
Heavy Urban Search Terrain 1? Yeah. Earth's contribution to a multi-species disaster response unit. HUST-1, but Hustle looks much better on a patch. All civilians, retired vets, or shits like me. I was fiercely bearded. Tastes better just thinking about those days.
I wanted adventure and mystery at the edge of known space. There was so much to see. Seems like a long time ago.
600 years, give or take. So, Pathfinder, why Andromeda?
That blunt, huh?
That blunt.
I hoped my Alliance career would lead to adventure. Exploring, hunting dangers in the dark. Didn't happen. Couldn't. But here, everything's new. And I want to see it all.
Oh, I don't hear idealist a lot. Everyone's cynical.
Back at you, Costa. Why'd you come?
I want to say I'm running from my past, but really running from myself. That'd be a great story. But it's bullshit. I had family, friends, a good enough job, nothing was wrong. I just heard about the initiative and I believed in it. I believed in a new beginning. Still do. I have to. We're in it.
We can't go back. But we're not trapped by decisions, a galaxy behind us.
I don't feel trapped. We came from a good place for good reasons. We keep that in mind, it'll steer us right, just like back in Crisis Response. Remember the essentials. A new start, guided by the Pathfinder. And team. I'll bust my tail to make that a good story. Prodromos. Prodromos. Sounds good, doesn't it? We started Pathfinder. A new life. That is goddamn brilliant.
We barely covered how you joined. Tell me something about yourself.
All right. I was a bad student, piss poor cop, great responder. Had a good life, but it'd all been done. I wasn't looking to start over. I wanted to start big.
You were a cop then, Crisis Response? Couldn't have been long in either.
Didn't have the patience for law, so I figured enforcement. Dad knew it didn't fit before I did. But it got me into hustle. They mostly take vets and retired service. Best years of my life.
You found your place. Not everyone gets that.
I knew it. Glad for it every day. And that led me here.
Tell me about your family.
I miss the hell out of them. Some nights you just cry, right? That's the thing everyone does. Mom, Joelle. Dad, Calvin. Both lawyers. Met on the Citadel, settled on Earth. No brothers or sisters. That might have been too much to leave. It was traditional. How about you?
Life with my family was not typical, on a number of fronts.
You make do though, right? Family has to. I know mine did. I said goodbye to my mom and dad, and got on a ship to Andromeda.
We'll talk later.
I know it. Pathfinder.
Just wondering what you think of how I'm doing at the job.
I'm committed to the initiative. You're Pathfinder. It's as simple as it gets.
We'll talk later.
I know it.
Pathfinder, making the rounds.
Slumming it, huh? Wanna see how the riffraff are making out?
Hey, it's a dirty job. Are you the riffraff spokesman?
King, actually. You might want to bow. Otherwise, no telling what might fall off the Nomad when you're out there.
I'll take my chances. Just wanna see how things are going with the ship.
I can coax more out of this baby than some might think, but we shouldn't go too far or push too hard between Nexus stops. For now. It just feels good to be stretching our wings, you know? Locked in idle too long, you start to drift. People, same as ships. Stuck on the Nexus, gotta say, I was regretting joining the Initiative.
Seems like life back there was pretty bleak.
Not gonna lie, it sucked. I tend to live the way I work. Kind of feel it, do it. Not a lot of close ties. No real sense of purpose. Figured maybe I'd find my true calling in Andromeda. Then I got here and... oops, I just made a decision there's no turning back from. I was going nuts on that station. You can't know how jazzed I was when you showed up.
We're exploring this cluster, eventually the galaxy. If your purpose is here, we'll find it.
Then the question will be, what will I do with it? In the meantime, you just keep pointing this ship wherever you want it to go, and I'll make sure she can get there.
Deal?
Deal.
Long time no chat. What's up?
I hear we have you to thank for getting the Tempest space ready so quickly.
Vetra brings her impossible feats to me. I was itching to get this particular call. Capital R, ready. Don't tell her, but the truth is, I fudge reports to come in early, then bust ass in secret to make up for it. Expands the Gil legend. Plus, I convey calm and assurance, and the whole team relaxes, which helps them do their jobs better.
What's your social circle like?
I'm good for a laugh, so I know lots of people, but I don't let too many in. My one true friend is stationed on the Nexus. She's the only piece of the Milky Way I brought with me. The more you and I get to know each other, the more you'll probably hear about her.
How tough was it on the Nexus all those months?
Have you ever eaten overcooked space cow tongue?
Can't say I have.
Well, let me tell you, it's tough. Wondering if you're gonna die from a critical malfunction, or maybe starvation, imagining which would be worse. But hey, you could always take a break from the fear and boredom to dwell on being a part of the biggest failure in galactic history. Maybe even participate in a revolt.
What was your take on that?
I didn't place any bets, if that's what you're asking. Truth is, I don't think anyone made out particularly well. Whatever side you're on, you die a little when your brother, your teammate, becomes an enemy. We traveled all this way, all hope and wonder, and we end up fighting with each other over scraps. It's sad.
Seems like we have a good group here.
Well, Vetra and Suvi are my girls. Get along well. Lots of mutual respect. PB's a real spark plug. I like her, but she's exhausting. And Drak's my kind of guy. Brash. Takes no shit. As far as your Hyperion peeps go, Doc's kind of nosy. Liam's good for a laugh or two. Cora, she's a bit by the book for me.
Need somebody to keep the zoo in check.
Zoo? You calling me an animal rider? Ooh, can I be a mongoose? They're like cool cobra killers. No, wait, how about a crow? Smart, irreverent, obnoxious. That's it.
I'll take your word for it. What about Callow?
He's a pilot.
Which means...
he flies the ship.
We're leaving it at that then?
Does a Pathfinder know what to do with a dead end?
Good talking to you, Gil.
Anytime.
Hey, can you drop by the biolab?
Hi there.
See you later, Cora.
I'll be here.
My data pad. Oh, how'd you get under there?
Suvi, were you talking to your notebook?
Oh, I was, wasn't I? I do that sometimes.
this is where the human Ark first entered Helios?
Heck of a wake-up call. Anomaly on sensors. Probes launched. I found something. Probes launched. Getting a scan. Hit debris. Severe damage consistent with Ezo detonation.
Oh! I get it! Turian escape vector, right? Another of their tricks. Dumping fuel as last-ditch mines.
Our shuttle might still be out there?
Anomaly on sensors. Away. Anomaly found. Ryder, it's dark, but no. I'm getting low readings. Stasis fields.
Priority to the Nexus. We have a shuttle for retrieval with Site 2 survivors. Resilience, you are coming home.
That's the research vessel Dr. Aridana informed us of. There are no life readings within.
She'll want to know.
was about as far as the Nexus surveyors could get before, well...
Let's see what's waiting here. Anomaly on sensors. Deploying probe. Tracking a huge mineral deposit. Familiar territory. The Nexus has been here for months. Still not enough time to survey it all. Anomaly detected. Probes launched. I found something. Thank you.
Pathfinder, is it true? We're settling Eos.
We've thought that before.
But Eos is different now, right? Pathfinder.
All right, settle down. Give him space. Lieutenant Syax, Kendros' aide. They all wanted to see you. Real hope again. It's been a while.
They've got a Pathfinder again. This is what we do.
And you've done it splendidly.
Professor Herrick, right?
What you achieved with that remnant vault is unprecedented, Pathfinder. Impossible. But with new scientific talent waking up, we'll unravel those mysteries. The whole Nexus will benefit.
I can't believe you said that.
We've taken some hard knocks, but this proves we'll always get up again.
Always.
Well, what are you waiting for? There's a new world out there.
Thank you, Ryder.